Hello everyone, myself Anju Chopra, your maths teacher. Today we will study the chapter multiplication, chapter number 6. Part 1 of the chapter 6 already you have done, that is based on multiplication, related to the multiplication. So all of you, I think, understand that what is multiplication. So today, in this part 2, we will do only the word sums of exercise 6E. The word sums which are based on multiplication, we will do today. So, all of you are ready. I think all of you know the tables also. We will do the statement. The first question is, a building has 35 floors. Each floor has 8 flats. How many flats are there in the building? So try to understand the question first of all, then we will write the statements. That a building has 35 floors. How many floors are there? 35. And on each floor, 8 flats are there. Every floor is having 8 flats and you have to find out how many flats are there in the building. You have to find out if a building has 35 floors, each floor has 8 flats. So how many total flats are there in the building? So our first statement is, come to the statement, number of floors in the building equal 35. Now the next one, number of flats at each floor is 8. How many flats are there? 8 flats are there. So how many, when we will multiply 35 into 8, we will, the number will come 280. So 280 flats are there in the building, because in the building total floors are 35 and on each floor 8 flats are there. 35 into 8, 280 flats are there in the building. Here I have shown the multiplication also. Look here, 35 into 8 is equal to 280. Then we'll write the answer. The building has 280 flats. I think this is clear to all of you, that a building has 35 floors. Each floor has 8 flats. So when we will multiply 35 into 8, 280 flats are there in the building. Now come to the next. When your students will do the statement sums or the word sums, you have to write all the steps. Statements you have to write and you have to be very careful regarding the steps. Now question number 2. A bus makes 6 trips between Hora and Salt Lake every day. How many trips a bus lake make? 6 trips. Trips means from one place, the bus is going to another place 6 times. Every day means in one day. 64 people travel in the bus on each trip. In each trip, how many persons go in the bus? 64. So 64 persons go 6 times. Bus is making 6 trips. So you have to find out how many people travel in the bus every day. The first step is number of trips between Hora and Salt Lake equals 6. How many trips bus is making? 6 trips. And how many persons are going? Number of people travel in each trip equals 64. Number of people travel in the bus every day, 64 into 6, 384. So 384 people travel in the bus every day. 64 into 6 equals 384. So our answer is 384 people travel in a bus every day. Is it clear to all of you? If a bus is making 6 trips from one place to another place, and in each trip the bus is taking 65 persons. So how many persons travel in the bus every day? 384 64 into 6 equal 384 person travel in the bus every day. I think this question number 2 is clear to all of you. Now come to the next one. Third one, a box holds a dozen. A dozen means 12. How many things are there in a dozen? 12. A box holds a dozen pens. Means in one box, how many pens are there? 12 pens are there. How many pens are there in 72 such boxes? If one box have 12 pens, so how many pens are there in 72 boxes? 72 into 12. Very, very clear. Number of pen statement. First sentence is number of pens in one box equal 12. 12 means a one dozen. Next, number of pens in 72 boxes have 72 into 12. 864. How many? 864. When we will multiply 72 by 12, first of all, we will multiply by ones. Here the ones is 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 sevens are 14. So when we will multiply in the next step by tens, under ones, we will write either cross or zero, because we are not multiplying by ones, we are multiplying by tens. The answer will write under the tens only. 1 twos are 2, 1 sevens are 7, and when we will add it, the answer is 864. So how many pens are there in 72 boxes? 864 pens are there in 72 boxes. If one box have 12 pens and 72 boxes have 864 pens. Clear to all of you? Next one. A ream of paper means 50 sheets of paper. A ream is having 50 sheets. A ream is having 500 sheets. How many sheets are there? 500 sheets are there in one ream. How many sheets are there in 32 reams? If one ream having 500 sheets, how many sheets in 32? So 500 into 32. Come to the first step. Number of sheets in one ream of paper equal 500. How many sheets are there in one ream? 500 sheets. Next step, number of sheets in 32 reams of paper, 500 into 32 equals 16,000. So here is the multiplication I have shown, 500 into 32, the answer is 16,000 sheets are there. So how we'll write the answer? 32 reams have 16,000 sheets of papers. Clear to all of you? If one ream is having 500 sheets, how many sheets are present in 32? 500 into 32, the total are 16,000. Next one, if a meter of a cloth costs rupees 245, what is the cost of 1 meter of cloth? Rupees 245. What will be the cost of 36 meters of cloth? The cost of 1 meter of cloth is given. You have to find out the cost of 36 meters of cloth. So what you will do? You will multiply 245 into 36. So first step is, cost of 1 meter of cloth equal rupees 245. Cost of 36 meters of cloth equal rupees 245 into 36 equal 8,820. So let's see how I have multiplied. 245 into 36 First of all, multiply by 6. Then we will get 1470. And when we will multiply 245 by 3, we will get 735. And when we will add these two, our product is 8820. So what is the answer? The cost of 36 meter of cloth equal rupees 8820. Is it clear to all of you? The cost of 1 meter of cloth is given. You have to find the cost of 36 meters of cloth. You will multiply these two and we will get the what product we will get. That is the cost of 36 meters of cloth. When you are writing any statement sum, you have to write all the statement and these units also. Whatever the units are of question, you have to write that units also. Now the next one, there are 178.50 rupee notes in a bag. Try to understand this sentence. 50 rupee notes are there in the bag. What kind of note? 50 rupee notes. And how many 50 rupee notes are there in the bag? 178. Means a bag is having 178.50 rupee notes. How much money is there in the bag? So one number is 178 and the another number is 50. So when we will multiply 178 by 50, we will come to know how much money is there in the bag. Because the bag is having only one kind of note and that is of 50 rupee note. So first statement sentence, value of 150 rupee note, rupees 50. If one note is equal to rupees 50, value of 178.50 rupee note equal 50 into 178. So how much we are getting? That is, when we will multiply 178 by 50, we will get 8,900. How much money is there in the bag? 8,900. Because bag is having only 50 rupees note. And how many notes of 50 rupee are there? 178. So 178 into 50, we'll come to know how much money is there in the bag. By multiplying these two, we will get 8,950 rupees notes are there. Next one, how many hours are there in the month of January? Students, I think all of you know, how many days are there in the month of January? January month is having 31 days. And in one day, how many hours are there? 24. So you have to find out that how many hours are there in the month of January. So let's see how we'll do it. Number of days in the month of January equal 31. Number of hours in one day, 24. In one day, we are having 24 hours. Number of hours in 31 days, because January is having 31 days. So how many hours are there in the month of January is, first of all, we will find how many hours. That is, multiply 31 into 24, 124, and this when we will multiply by 2, we will get 62. When we will add it, we are getting 744. How many hours are there in the month of January? 744. So is it clear to all of you? First of all, we will write change the January month into days, then days into hours. Then multiply the days by hours. We will come to know how many hours are there in the month of January, because January is having 31 days and one day is having 24 hours. So we will multiply 31 into 4 and we will get 744 hours. Next one is, each class in a school has 3 sections. Try to understand this sentence. Each class in a school has 3 sections. Means class 1, 2, 3, 4. Every class is having 3 sections. Maybe you can say A, B, C or anything. Each class is having how many sections? 3 sections. Each section has 40 students. In one section, how many students are there? 40 students. So how many students are there in one class? Because one class has 3 sections. And each section have 40 students. So how many students in each section? 40 into 3. That is 120. Each class has 120 students. We have to find, let us see what we have to find. What is the total number of students in class 1 to 10? You have to find, if one class is having 120 students, so how many students are there from class 1 to 10? Let us see how we'll find out. Statements are, number of sections in each class equal 3. Number of students in each section equal 40. Number of students in each class equal 40 into 3 equal 120. Number of classes in a school, 1 to 10, means total 10 classes are there. Here, look here, it is given classes 1 to 10. Classes 1 to 10 means total classes are 10. Number of students in a school equal 120 into 10. Because in one class, 120 students are there. In 10 classes, how many students are there? 120 into 10, 1200 students. First of all, we will multiply 40 by 3 because each section having 40 students and each class have 3 sections. In one class, how many students are there? 120. And total classes are 10. If one class have 120 students, so 10 classes have 1200 students. First of all, we will find out how many students in one class, then we will find out how many students in 10 classes. So our answer is, total number of students in class 1 to 10 are 1200. I hope it's clear to all of you. Now we will do home assignment. We will do these only 8 questions. Total there are 11 sums are there in exercise 6E. The remaining sums I'll give you homework. You do it and I'll send solution afterward. You check your solutions. Exercise 6E, do sums 9 to 11. Total 11 questions are there. 8 we have done. The remaining 9, 10, 11, these 3 questions you have to do in your classwork copy. Afterward, I will send the solution. You check your sums. Because we are at home due to lockdown, we are not going to school. So with this, your chapter 6E is over. I hope all of you understand it. Thank you. Have a nice day.